This video is brought to you by my supporters on Patreon, Buy Me a Coffee, and YouTube. If you'd like to support me, you can find the links below. I've said on multiple occasions that the main reason why religion survives is because of childhood indoctrination. This is true of every single religion, be it Hinduism or Islam or Christianity, you name it. Before a child learns how to think, it's taught what to think. And sometimes this indoctrination is so strong that even if the child develops critical thinking later in life, he or she never applies it to their own religion. There are things they learned in their own religion, and there's everything else. And critical thinking only happens here. There are such examples in every religion, but none have fascinated me more than how Muslims try to deny evolution. Christians do a similar thing, but maybe we'll look at that in a different video. Islam has a really interesting way of rationalizing it when anything discovered goes against their holy books. So much so that they have entire videos on YouTube teaching people how to rationalize these things. Today we're gonna look at one such video and exercise some critical thinking as we go along. My name is Pranav, you're watching scienceisdope. Let's begin. I have to begin by saying this video has a lot of really good animation work that has gone into it. It kind of reminds me of Gazgazat, so props to you for that. Now, I have to urge the channel owner not to copyright strike me because all I'm doing is commenting on your video, which is fair use. But I'm assuming this kind of discourse and discussion is something you invite. Let's look at the video.
There are two reasons why Muslims don't have to change their beliefs to fit Darwinian evolution. Number one, science does not lead to certainty. And number two, Darwin's theory of evolution is not indisputable.
Alright, let's talk about each of his reasons. First, you're right, science doesn't lead to certainty. There's no absolute knowledge possible in science. But you know what? Nothing empirical leads to a certainty. Things that deal with reality, the real world that we experience, are all empirical. Not just science, but economics, psychology, sociology, these are all empirical. And you know what else is empirical? Religion. It deals with empirical stuff like our experiences, the kinds of people there are in the world, making sense of nature, etc. Now, if science doesn't lead to certainty, you seem to be implying that something else does. Your holy books? Nothing empirical that deals with the same things that science does a better job than science. And when you look for certainty, you have to ask yourself this. Do you want knowledge that never improves and stays the same? Or do you want knowledge that improves, that constantly updates itself with every new thing you learn?
So Darwinian evolution can be accepted by Muslims as a valid theory, but not something absolutely true.
You're right, Darwin's theory of natural selection is not indisputable. In fact, it is not even the currently accepted theory of evolution. Darwinian evolution doesn't have any knowledge of genetics, epigenetics, DNA, etc. What biologists accept today is called the modern synthesis of evolution, which includes Darwinian ideas as only a part of it. And when you say not absolutely true, you have to recognize that nothing empirical is absolutely true. Take the latest accepted theory in physics, general relativity. It's not absolutely true. Then why do we still accept it? Or better yet, why do no religions have a problem with it, unlike evolution? Because evolution goes against the God created the world idea in the Quran and the Bible.
Basic evolution is biological change over time.
Caterpillars turning into butterflies, that's not evolution, my friend. Maybe if this was a world of Pokemon, but it isn't. This is called metamorphosis. And if you're calling any biological change as evolution, then you're changing the meaning of the term. Evolution requires survival and reproduction and passing on of traits over multiple generations. When you call any biological change as evolution, one has to wonder, are you deliberately changing the meanings of words in order to cause confusion?
Darwinian evolution is composed of two parts. Number one, the tree of life, and number two, natural selection.
Okay, now we're getting somewhere.
The basic type of evolution is simply true. Yeah, it happens all around us. Take butterflies or bacteria evolving resistance to medicine and numerous other examples. Yeah, no one disagrees with this type of biological evolution.
The bacteria example you gave is an example for natural selection. Why do bacteria become resistant to antibiotics? The antibiotics kill off most of the bacteria, but the few that are resistant survive and pass on their resistance to the next generation. Now, no matter how many antibiotics you have, these resistant bacteria will continue to survive and reproduce. And they're just going to produce more resistant bacteria. This is how antibiotic resistance develops. And this is natural selection. They don't magically become resistant.
Which requires more evidence for the tree of life and natural selection other than mere observations.
I think you're confused regarding what the term evidence means. Evidence is observation. It may either be direct observation or observing the result of an experiment or indirect inference from an observation. Either way, there is no evidence without observation. Also, I would have loved to hear what evidence this channel would accept to change their views, but that's not mentioned.
Sadly, people confuse the two types together and assume proof for the former is proof for the latter.
It seems to me like no matter what level of evidence you see, you'll find a way to deny it.
And this is not to mention some of the problems with regards to Darwinian evolution. Number one, no matter how successful a scientific theory is, it can always be changed and challenged due to new observations and interpretations.
We keep coming back to this over and over again. A scientific theory can always be challenged. Oh, we don't know that it's 100% true. Why are you waiting for it to be 100% true? Okay, let's use this analogy to understand what's the problem with demanding 100% truth. Let's say you're in court. You're accusing me of murdering someone. You found a murder weapon with my fingerprints on it. But I can just say, hey, this only proves that I held the murder weapon, not that I committed the murder. The investigators now find DNA evidence. Maybe my hair was found at the scene and a witness comes forward saying that they saw me run away from the scene. And I can just say, hey, this only means that I was at the crime scene. Doesn't prove that I committed the murder. Even if the court finds actual CCTV footage of me committing the murder, I can just say, hey, this CCTV footage has been edited by someone who's clearly trying to frame me. I can keep dodging all the accusations like this, but after a point, the court is gonna find me guilty of murder because the court doesn't need to know 100% that I committed the crime. It just needs to know beyond any reasonable doubt that I'm the murderer, and it has enough evidence for that. Now, is there a possibility that I'm not the murderer? Sure, but it's extremely unlikely. Theories in science are exactly the same way. The modern theory of evolution is something confirmed by countless pieces of evidence and well accepted by every legitimate biologist in the field that it's foolish to believe that it's not the case.
Number two, the tree of life is based on the idea of homology, which is the assumption that two species with similar genes and anatomy have evolved from a common ancestor. Left as it is, it's just an assumption, not a conclusion based on evidence.
All right, now this is just a plain lie. Homology is not an assumption. You can observe and conclude the similarity in bone structure across different mammals, like monkeys and bats and whales, and they clearly show that they're all descended from a common ancestor that had this bone structure.
Yet, there is a problem, homeoplasy. Homeoplasy is the observation of similarities which cannot be due to common ancestry.
Yeah, but what does this have to do with homology though? Homoplasy is just a consequence of convergent evolution. Mammals and insects and birds and reptiles have all evolved wings separately, but their function is the same. How does this refute homology though?
Number three, gradualism. Darwin assumed evolution takes place in small, slight steps. This assumption is an essential part of Darwin's theory. In fact, he actually said that this is like a falsification condition to his entire framework. But the fossil record shows the exact opposite. Rapid changes in biological features also.
What are these rapid changes you're talking about? You've given no examples. At this point, I'm convinced this video is only trying to appeal to people who already agree with the ideas presented in this video to help them confirm what they already believe. They're not gonna scrutinize this and look through this in a skeptical manner. And that's what this channel seems to have been hoping for.
Number four, selfishness. Darwinism assumes that the only reason for our existence is to selfishly care for our own survival and reproduction. But it doesn't explain why many people give charity anonymously, why governments collect taxes for hospitals to help survival of the unfittest.
I agree with you here, but you know what? That's why Darwinism is not the currently accepted theory of evolution. Selfishness and altruism, helping others, can both be explained by gene-centered evolution, as explained in the book The Selfish Gene.
Number 5. Some notable biologists and philosophers have pointed out that there is propaganda about Darwinism, and they see it being pushed as an undeniable reality when it is far from it. In fact, some have even labeled Darwinism as a religion due to the activities of Darwinists.
To be honest, this part of the video is what sounds like propaganda to me. Darwinism is a scientific theory, one that is not currently accepted by mainstream science because it has shortcomings. And calling it a propaganda is not the same as saying it's wrong. And the only people who say that Darwinism claims to be the undeniable reality are the ones trying to misinform their audience about Darwinism.
In addition to this, Darwinism isn't even the only theory of evolution. In fact, let me just give you three alternatives. Number one, evolution by natural genetic engineering. Number two, neo-Lamarckian evolution. And number three, mutation-driven evolution. What was the point of all this,
Yeah, what is the point of all this? I mean, judging by the title of your video, I thought you were gonna give reasons to reconcile Darwinism with Islamic beliefs, not give more reasons to go against Islamic beliefs. Like, I don't know how any of these reasons you gave validate your beliefs, but let's see what you have to say.
I'm not trying to tell you that this theory is invalid. Yeah, it's still the main scientific theory to explain biological change.
No, it's not. Biology has gone well past Darwinism. The most accepted theory in evolutionary biology today is the modern synthesis.
Mentioning the disagreements above is done only to show that Darwinism is not an eternal truth set in stone as some may have us believe. So how can this be reason enough to make Muslims change their beliefs about the Creator and the Quran's view of the creation of mankind?
The mistake being made here is that there is no empirical idea that can be set in stone. If you're gonna wait for such a thing before you change your beliefs, then you're probably only looking for an excuse to keep your beliefs, and you were probably unwilling to change them in the first place. The theme of videos on this channel can often be unfriendly towards sponsors. As a result, I have to support myself and this content on generous support from all of you. The platforms Patreon and Buy Me Coffee are the ones I recommend for support because they take a smaller share of that revenue. Alternately, you can also support me on YouTube through memberships or that thanks button. You can also check out my website and my merch, links are down below. If you like this video, then you might also like this one I did on how Zakir Naik tries to deny evolution. I'll see you in the next one. Till then, remember, science is dope.